Hi guys, I'm Dave. Welcome to Beer Virtually. Today we have something that is, I think, pretty special in the craft beer world. This is Bell's Expedition Stout. And this has quite the reputation for being a fantastic stout. I have never had it. I've heard that it's very good. So we're going to get into it. Cool bottle cap. It has the like a compass cross on the top. It's pretty cool. This one's going in the mason jar. Oh man, the smell is right off the bat. This smells barrel age, but I don't think it is. Pours quite dark, not black, but it pours very dark. No head. So the initial smell, you get there's some dark fruit, chocolate, and coffee smells almost. Definitely a little bit of alcohol smell also. But not like in the boozy sense, just alcohol. Take a first sip. Wow, the very very toasty, malty, almost nutty. I mean, and it tingles your tongue. It like excites your tongue. A lot of body to it. A lot of flavor. A lot of stuff going on your tongue. Let's see what we got here for some stats on this one. 10.5% ABV. So we talked a couple back in the beginning about Imperials. So I've come to understand that, I mean, there's a number of different reasons things are called Imperials, but in general, anything, I think 8% or higher is considered an Imperial. It goes back to this. This is a Russian Imperial Stout, which is the true sense of where the Imperial comes from, because it was sold to the Imperial Court in Russia from England. That's where the name came from. 78 IBUs. I would not have expected that. That is the highest IBUs we've reviewed here on the channel. I definitely would not have guessed. I would have guessed around 50. It's not bitter, per se. I really need to do some research on how they come up with IBUs. And as it smells, a lot of alcohol smell coming out of it. There's definitely more alcohol smell than there is flavor, because it doesn't taste very alcoholish. The very simple Bell's, very kind of traditional Bell's labeling. It's got the compass and it says Expedition Stout on it. Again, it's from Comstock, Michigan. The bottle says Russian Imperial Stout. This Russian Imperial Stout thirsts for travel. A huge malt body is matched with a blend of complex chocolate, dark fruit, and roasted aromas. This beer is ready to be enjoyed now or sit perfectly content in your cellar until the next journey. So they say this ages well, too. Like, you know, a year or so down the road is supposedly pretty good in the bottle. $17.99 a six-pack. It's definitely not cheap. I see why they get $17.99 a six-pack. It is not as good as the Bell's Black Note Stout. That is, I mean, as far as stouts go, that's probably my favorite. Although, we've got some stuff coming up. I have Last Buffalo in the Park and Maple Bacon Porter from Funky Buddha, which may rival that. This is only put out in September, and like I just said, this is the highest IBUs of any beer we've reviewed so far at 78. That being said, though, it's quite drinkable. I don't know if I'd want to have two. It is slightly heavy. Some of it may be that complex and slight hoppiness mixed together. And I don't know if it's even hoppiness. Just the way it sits on your tongue is kind of the how a hoppier IPA would sit on your tongue. But then you have the smooth chocolate and dark fruits and coffee and toasted notes that kind of almost battle that. It's almost like a black IPA, but more creamier and richer, like a stout. Man, flavors and scents. A couple of these, I think you would definitely feel at over 10% ABV. That'll creep up on you if you're not careful. So today's Valentine's Day. Happy Valentine's Day, everybody. Today's also kind of sad. There was a mass shooting at the high school I went to. Very shocking, surprising. I'm kind of at a loss and saddened by the whole thing, by the state of what people think is acceptable and how to treat other people. It's very sad. So when I think of my life and I think of the stuff that I enjoy, the people I love and people I care about, it makes doing this little hobby a little more important. It makes me enjoy it a little bit more. So, happy Valentine's Day, everybody. And I wish people would just do the right thing. This is a toast to people just doing the right thing and not being assholes. Now to bring it back up on a high note. Man, there's so much good beer out, and just the craft beer industry in general just continues to pour out delicious, unique. It is, I mean, if you just think, just a few years back, you had to go out of your way to get different beers. If you went to a bar, there was Miller Lite, Bud Light, Budweiser, maybe Michelob, McUltra maybe. And then Yingling came around. I think Yingling, in Florida anyway, Yingling I think is brewed here in Tampa, the stuff that's distributed here. So Yingling, that was around, 2000 maybe? So going back 15, 18 years ago. That may have been kind of the turning point for when the craft beer, it's probably been a 15, 20 year trek of craft beer. And now the microbrew scene with all these little, so a beer like Bell's, right, it's from Michigan, but everybody knows Bell's. If you drink craft beer, you know what Bell's is, and you've probably had a number of their beers. I've reviewed a number of them already, so I've had at least half a dozen beers from Bell. And it's such a quality brand, I want to try everything of theirs. But there's so much stuff out there that some stuff just doesn't, there's some other stuff grabs my attention. And that's also an interesting proposition too, because I work in printing, and I've worked in marketing, where I've worked for a marketing company before. So it's often, I think about what influences me when I make a purchase or or when something piques my interest or something like that. And there's been a number of things I've mentioned, like Duclaw Dirty Little Freak. I mean, that the name totally intrigues me. As a guy, sex sells, even if it's not not visible, so to speak. But bells, knowing that bells from their quality, I mean, if I had a brand of beer, bells is the way to go. I mean, everything they do is just, it's the best quality. I mean, it really, really is. Dogfish Head's probably in that arena also. Dogfish Head might venture into some more weird stuff than Bell's does. Bell's, if I had a guess, would be a solid business. I don't know what their books look like, but if I had a guess, I would guess they make money because everything they make is good. So some of the stuff that Dogfish Head makes is kind of out there, and if people like trying weird stuff like I do, it might sell, but it's probably not for the masses. All of it is. But they have some stuff that is, like the 60-minute and 90-minute IPA, probably do very well just because it's just a known, it's probably one of, it's probably their two core beers, and it's just very well known. This is a good stout. It is, I got kind of spoiled with the Bell's Black Note stout, though, I gotta tell you. So I bought a 4-pack, and I've only drank the one that I had here on the channel. And I've been just, waiting for a good time to try to break out any of the other three. Something special, a special occasion or something, because they're so good. I mean, I hold them at such a high regard. That being said, I think I rated the Bell's Black Note Stout a 4.5. And I'm going to rate this a 4.25. Just the quality that comes through, the flavors, the scents. It's such a organized flavor in your mouth, but still chaotic at the same time. It's what a great beer should be. At the bottom already. So until next time, cheers.